Hey guys, my name is Tom Lipsey, and I am a lifelong minister of the gospel in different contexts, and I would like to share a little bit of my story with you if I could, okay? I was born and raised in the buckle of the Bible Belt in Memphis, Tennessee, and my dad was a worship leader, pastor at our church. So as a child, I went to church at least three times a week, Sunday morning, Sunday night, and Wednesday night. And I got exposed to biblical teaching early in my life. I must say that my church experience was one of very strong legalism, a lot of rules, a lot of do's, a lot of don'ts. And even as a child, I would look at the leaders around me in the church and just kind of think to myself, something seems to be missing if they talk about this wonderful life that God has, but people looked pretty sour to me. But when I was 14 years old, I ended up chasing a brunette that I was interested in, who eventually became my wife, on a retreat. I'd never been on a retreat in my life, but I went to Gatlinburg, Tennessee from Memphis. And I still remember to this day, and this was 50 years ago, going to the bus that morning to ride to Gatlinburg with a lot of other young people. And the minute I got on the bus, I just thought, man, these people are nice. They had a lot of love. They had a lot of laughter. They had a lot of joy. They had purpose and passion. And I'd not been around that. I'd been around church people. And so I'd had a religious experience, but nothing very intimate. And so by the end of that week, I heard the gospel. I heard all these different people that had so much joy and passion and love in their hearts say that they came to a place where they realized they needed a Savior, and that they did not think that they could work their way to God. That was counter to what I had been taught, but they understood that Jesus did the work on the cross. And so they accepted Christ as their Lord and Savior, and by the end of the week in Gatlinburg, I did that. And I will tell you, it was a game changer for me, and it changed the whole trajectory of my life. So I ended up going away to college, and I ended up working in Young Life, a parachurch organization that shares the good news of Jesus with high school kids. I stayed with them for 6 years, and so through the years, I saw hundreds of kids come to faith. And at the end of my 6 year tenure with them, I felt called to be a pastor. I realized that if kids didn't get into good, strong churches, they did not fare well. And so I went away to seminary, married my wife, and I became a pastor, and I pastored churches. I ended up pastoring three churches over a 30-year period. And once again, I saw God do so many awesome things. I saw so many people come to faith, trade their religion for a relationship, trade their sin bondage for salvation freedom because of a personal, intimate relationship with Jesus. And I ended up losing my wife to cancer 4 years ago after we were married 36 years. And dated 10, so I was super blessed to have her. But I came back to Cincinnati at that time where my children were and my grandkids. And I came back to plant a church, but however, God had different plans. And so I have ended up serving in the inner city at a mission that is called the Lord's Gym, Focus Ministries. That's an acrostic that stands for Foundation of Compassionate American Samaritans. And so today, I serve as the director of community partnerships and development, and it is the thrill of my life. I always thought the last chapter of my life would be sent with the less fortunate and with the poor, and that's what I get to do. We have three facilities. We have a six-step process where we go to where the people are. So I live in Price Hill, Cincinnati. I call it a war zone. We create a safe environment for our friends. We work with the indigent poor, the addicted, the trafficked. And we are a no-judgment zone. We love people unconditionally. We create this awesome, safe place. And if those things take place well, we normally can share the gospel with people, and they hear it. And then we get to disciple them. And in the very end, our goal is that a person would begin to live responsibly. And we have found in the relationship with Jesus that that can happen. So as I say today, man, I'm a happy camper. I'm so blessed. I can't even believe it. I go to bed fulfilled. I wake up fulfilled. And I have the joy of working with an awesome inner city team. And I'm just super thankful. So I really hope that you would consider the claims of the gospel, that God loves you and he's got an awesome plan for your life, and that you can realize that plan through a personal saving faith in Jesus Christ. So thanks for listening to me. I wish you all well, and I say God bless you. Peace.